Minasan, konnichiwa. Today, we will have to explain to you a very important engineering application for every one of us, for virtually every engineers, every engineering disciplines. However, we will start at residential, meaning to say those structure with one or two family dwelling. Okay, so let us go to this document. We will use the reference, textbook by Black and Decker. So it is what? It is in the United States. So electrical, mechanical, plumbing, building codes of year 2015 to 2017. So there might be some changes nowadays because, for example, there are NFPA codes released 2018, and but there are some very small changes in this code. So also, we will explain this. I am not the author of this textbook. I will just explain it and justify our explanation, wherein we will introduce the Philippine setting, how it is in the Philippines. There might be some differences. Obviously, there might be some differences. For example, the obvious difference is that Philippines only has two seasons, while in United States, they have four seasons the whole year. Okay, so let us continue. So we have the following contents. Introduction. We will explain some details regarding the convention and permits that is being implemented in the United States. And we will also explain how about in our country. Building, design, and safety for Chapter 2. And structural components for Chapter 3. So foundation like that, decking, flooring, walling system. So this has something to do with structural engineer or civil engineer, okay? And you will notice that building design and safety for Chapter 2 is actually conglomeration of different disciplines, but mainly egress door, for example, hazard. So with respect to safety, no? Safety engineering, okay? And there might be some fire protection safety that is included in the chapter. So Chapter 3 is for civil, and Chapter 4, exterior components. Okay, so what are the other possibilities? So, and Chapter 5 is heating and air conditioning. So this is more of mechanical engineering application. Okay, plumbing system is Chapter 6. So plumbing engineering. And Chapter 7, electrical system, electrical engineering. And some appendix and conversion chart. So those are something that we could expect in this I will try if we can make this a little bit bigger so that everybody could really be able to at least read the outline. Okay? So let us make it a little bit bigger. Let us change the font. Okay, so that it looks better. And what is this? Ah, here. Okay. So let us set up our font size. So make it larger. Okay. So let us try this. Let us try. Okay, so it's better. We can actually see the words. Okay. So let us go back to the contents. So contents. Okay. So again, we have what? Introduction, too large. Okay, let us change the font. This is too large, so let us make it 50. How about 50? About 50. Okay. Let us try this. Okay, it's better. So, again, chapter 1, introduction. Chapter 2, building safety. We have safety engineering and fire protection. And chapter 3 is again structural components, civil engineers, and exterior components for chapter 4. Chapter 5 is mechanical engineering. Chapter 6 is plumbing engineering. Chapter 7 is electrical engineering. And that's all. So we'll do it in this same approach. Okay? So again, that is what you have to expect in our video. And let us go immediately to chapter 1, introduction. Okay. So the purpose of the 2015 International Residential Code. So this is the code that could be used in several countries, residential code. So this is for a small structure, one or two dwelling units. And of all building codes, for that matter, is presented in IRC section R 101.3. The purpose of this code is to establish minimum requirement to safeguard the public safety, health, and general welfare. Okay? Very similar. National Building Code of the Philippines states that protection of life, property, public health, and public welfare. Almost the same, no? Almost the same with this objective. Okay? This statement provides important information about building codes. And codes inspections. Building codes are minimum requirements. A house built to minimum requirement is not necessarily a high-quality house built by craftsmen according to best practices. Code inspections are about safety and health. That's why that is the purpose of the code. Protection of, in the National Building Code, protection of life, property, public health, and public safety. But in this document, the objective is public health and public welfare, public safety. Right? So, what is public safety? Protection of life and property. So, almost the same, no? Different wordings, different phrase, but almost the same. There might be some technical and legal discrepancy between the two, but anyway, from the point of view of urban engineering, work, that is the same. Okay? Code inspections are about safety and health. They are not about fit, finish, and other cosmetic issues. Okay? Although in National Building Code, we have architectural. So, what is that? Fit, finish, and other cosmetic issues. Because in the United States, architectural has a different standard from IRC. So IRC is more on engineering. It is engineering codes and standards. So in the Philippines, engineers and architects are combined into one group. That's why we include fit, finish, and cosmetic. Okay? They are not even about functional issues that are not specifically addressed in the code. So, we have functional issues addressed in the code, but we have also functional that are not addressed in the code. So, the code is very specific. Okay? Very specific. So, not all that you learned from electrical engineering will be addressed by the code. Not everything that you learn from mechanical engineering will be addressed by the code. Not all that you learn from civil engineering will be addressed by the code. Okay? Only those who are relevant with respect to the point of view of the IRC committee. Okay? So, understanding the purpose of building code helps you set realistic expectations about the limits of building codes and code inspections. What can we expect? Why are they expecting? What are they looking at? Are they looking at my area because of what? What are they expecting about? So, knowing these basic principles will give us an idea how inspection will going to take place. Okay? Building code change must do so on 3-year cycle. So, usually this is the work of the committee. They, after a building code version is released, they already starting the checking, the proofreading and feedback mechanism from the association's member, and taking note of this feedback and submitting this notes and proposal or proposed revision to the committee, and the committee will again finalize and approve what particular changes would be made to the present code that would be implemented on the next release of the code version. Okay? So, 3 years. So, however, in the Philippines, that is not true. It's not true. In the United States, this is almost always the case. There are only some exemption. In the Philippines, it is reversed. There are no regular updating. There's no regular updating of codes, and only on special occasion that they have. So the situation is reversed. No? Okay. So many codes changes are little more rewarding or reorganization in an attempt to make code provision easier to understand. Some of the changes are just terminology. They want to unify the terminology. What are you using in that state? So there are several states in the United States. 50 states, I think. So 50 states. What word are you using technically on that state? What word are you using on that state? So let us unify. Okay? So what are the changes because of technological change? What are now the umbrella technical word that could be used rather than the old technical term? Okay, so those are some of the changes. Many code changes and additional additions are substantive, and homeowners should be aware of this as they perform repairs and remodeling projects. So should be aware. So their awareness of engineering technology is so much that even the homeowners should be aware of these things. In the Philippines, homeowners, particularly residences, are almost always exempted for any code provisions, national building code provision. They are almost always exempted. They are not being penalized. In this area alone, in this barangay, if the code will be implemented strictly, nobody in this residential area will not be penalized. Everybody will be penalized in this area. Okay? They are not following any codes. Okay? Because why? They are not aware. And why they are not aware? Because those who have the capacity to enforce and bring awareness to the masses, to the community, are not doing their effort, are not making efforts to let these people be aware and get their home safety as possible. No? They are not making any move to make this happen. That's why only commercial, industrial, institutional, and businesses are being monitored by the authorities in our country. Unlike in United States or in other countries, in other developed countries. In developed countries, they are being monitored, even the residential owners. One substantive addition changes are reasons for this updated edition of codes for homeowners. One change in addition to the 2015 international code involves the section on decks, and we have expanded the deck section of this book to reflect these changes. Okay? Decks are one of the most frequent source of injuries and fatalities of any structure in and around the home. So, falling deck. Even school buildings, big school buildings in the United States, suffers what? Falling debris, falling deck, flooring fall down. So, this happens in the United States. I'm aware because of I am what following the news pertaining to structural discipline, because I am a civil engineer. I am interested to follow the civil engineering discipline. Okay. So the expanded deck section provides important information. So meaning the code has an expanded coverage to help you build the deck that complies with 2015 International Residential Code requirements. It will also point you to information that will help you go beyond minimum code requirements and build your deck according to best practices. So this is a matter for best practices. We can decide to adopt this code in the Philippines, but we're not. We have our national building code for structural, and they are not so much into it. Okay. Okay. Another substantive change to the 2015 IRC involves energy efficiency. And we all want to use less energy in our homes, not only to save environment, but to save money. So again, we can implement this as soon as we design the building, the residential home. Structurally, we can have a thought on the energy conservation. And mostly, this energy conservation could be answered by mechanical, electrical, plumbing, design. But of course, because of that, structural systems is also affected. Okay? So they have to do it at the onset of design. Okay. So, not only to save environment, but to save money. We have added significant new section to additional codes for homeowners that will not only help you understand new code requirements, but also provides tips on how you can save energy and money. So, trying to condense a 900 page, but on our system, this is 1,500. Pages, okay? Because what? We increase the font size of the document. So 900 code book, that is mostly text and tables in a very small print, to significantly fewer pages filled with pictures and illustration. Okay? It's a challenging task. So because some owners will not use them if the code is not updated. So they are updating this regularly. The provisions we include have been simplified to make them easier to understand. This means the codes for homeowners is not your local building code. This is not. This is just a textbook that explains the IRC provision. Your local building code, as interpreted by your building inspector, is the code with which you must comply. You must do so, okay. You have to comply to one brand. AHJ, authority having jurisdiction. They are the inspectors. They will inspect your system. So in the Philippines, there is no such inspection if the building is residential and according to building code, any building should be inspected. But they are not implemented in the Philippines if we are talking about residential. So according to what we studied and what we know of in structural engineering, those buildings with second floor must have minimum requirements for structural, and those building with more than 100 square meters, even though you do not have second floor, but your area is 100 square meters, you have to follow the building code. That is the minimum in the Philippines. However, if you're asking for a permit from the government, from EHJ, authority having jurisdiction, and permit for what? Residential. Then you are immediately exempted from those requirements. Why is that? That is not okay. Actually, that is not okay. If you are hearing this presentation and you are a residential owner or you are a homeowner, that is not good for you because you are risking your life and your family members' lives. Okay, take note. There is a viral news wherein there is a residential building that collapsed in Miami, Florida, United States. Okay? And there are several dozens of about 50, 60 deaths, fatally wounded, and many are not yet found. They are what? Under the collapsed building. So how can you find all of the cadavers, all of the bodies? It's very difficult. So you are risking. So anyway, that is not a single or two-family dwelling, but here there are even four-story residential building with no engineering plan. With no engineering plan, that is not good for your family's lives. Okay, that is not good to risk your family's lives by not. How much is, for example, how much is the cost of engineering plan? Even if you pay an engineer $400,000, is $100,000 enough? About $100,000. That is for you to pay an engineer to have an engineering plan, for example, $100,000. I think $100,000 is a good payment for an engineer if it will add to the safety of your family. If it will add to the safety of your family, $100,000 is, oh, if you are what? Poor in a family. If you are poor in the family and all of you died with that building, how much will be your expenses? More than $100,000. More than $100,000. So it is better to pay an engineer and save your family's lives rather than take a risk. You are taking a risk. The authority having jurisdiction are not very strict because you are residential. But do not think that you are exempted really from having an engineering plan. Those are just consideration for you to decide. You are the one to decide. Do you want an engineering plan or not? Okay, no? Okay. We will give you permit. So that's why you are what? You are risking your family's life. They are very strict in commercial. Why? The difference between commercial and residential is that commercial establishments are for public use. Public. There are other persons. There are so many persons. There are different persons that will go inside the facility. However, in your residential, only your family is almost always at any given time there. And some very small time, there might be some visitors. But almost always, only your family are involved. You are what? You are responsible for your family. But the commercial establishments are responsible for the public safety. So that is one very important difference. And because you are not being asked by the government to submit engineering plan, if you are residential, maybe you can think like this. I am a residential owner. I am a homeowner. I am not required to submit engineering plan. Is this government really don't care about us as a family? They only care about the public in general. They are not going to care for individual family? Oh. That is the question that you should think about. So that's why, actually, you are not being asked for the engineering plan, but you can hire an engineer to do it for you. Nobody is prohibiting you to get an engineer and plan your structure. So you can do it for your family safety, not for the requirement of the government. Okay? Because you care for your family, the government may not care for your family. The government only cares for the public welfare. That's why the objective of this is public welfare. Okay? Okay. So there is a small difference. Okay? If you have any doubts or questions about how a building code provision applies in your area, you should ask your local building inspectors. That is called building officials in our country. They are building official. You have to go to the city hall and look for the city engineer or municipal hall, municipal engineer. Ask for who is the municipal engineer, who is the authority having jurisdiction. If you look for authority having jurisdiction, nobody will be able to give you an answer. But if you look for who is the municipal engineer, somebody will be able to point you to the right direction. Okay? So, in almost every case, if you approach them as a resource and not as an obstacle, approach this engineer as a helper. They will help you to provide you with safety. With what? Professional fee. Professional fee is not so much. Professional fee is not so much. I am just telling you about 100,000. What is a 100,000 in your building? If you have a two-story building, you will what? You will spend two-story building in the Philippines, very economical way of doing it, using what? Skilled workers without hiring engineers. You can do a two-story building by about 300,000. 300,000 with a total habitable area of about 60 square meters. 60 square meters, okay, 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, and all of the necessities, kitchen and so on, living room, 60 square meters, you will spend about 300,000 and add 100,000 for the engineer, and then you are getting a very good dwelling for your family. Okay? So, we are not thinking about that. We are thinking that all of these engineers are what? Obstacle on my dreams to have a happy home, a residential of my own. Okay? So, we are thinking negatively. Okay? You will find your local inspectors to be friendly, knowledgeable, and eager to help. They will help you. They will help you. So, this is the time for us to change our perspective against engineer. Engineers are not obstacle. Engineers are not going there to get all your money. Engineers are there to help you. Okay? Okay? Codes and permits, the basic. In just the United States, you will find hundreds of code books. This is true. Describing thousands upon thousands of building code provisions. On top of this, there are even more books that look and feel like code books, but are really only attempting to describe best practices. Actually, almost all of those publications in the United States are almost always, majority, I think 90% are just best practices. But although they are best practices, some of the states and some other countries are adapting, they adapt these best practices as code of their country, as code of their states, and so on. That's why they what? They grow influence. They grow their coverage around the world. Okay? So best practices at the start. Okay? Almost all of these have their own inherent value, but almost none of them apply to typical home owners living in typical single family home. So this is different. This is different. This is for small scale structure. So single family home structure. Are those single family homes exempted from safety? Are they exempted from safety? Okay. Are all of their members Superman and Superwoman, that they do not fear any accident happening to their structure, while all the other members of the society are having their safety on their side, on their workplaces, on their public places. We in the residential area do not ask for this. So this is about time. This is about time that we have to think about homeowners, single family, two family dwellings, or following the codes. Okay? So this is actually my advocacy. This is actually my advocacy. I already have some engineering plan signed and sealed, sometimes, almost always, what, by donation and very small fee. Okay, very small fee. Almost give away engineering plan for residential. But for commercial, I will ask for the right amount of payment for professional fee. But for residential owners, 5,000, 10,000, 2,000 sometimes, right? Okay? So that is enough for your signature. Okay? So for residential, this is my advocacy. Okay? So I am concentrating here because we need also engineering plan for the safety of homeowners. So the hardest thing about building code is learning how to tell which one applies to you. And if there is a disagreement, which takes precedence? So this is always the case. There are provisions that are in contrast with each other. Okay? We will explain that. As an introduction, here are some brief biographies of more common codes and enforcement agencies you're likely to encounter. The International Residential Code, or this document, IRC. Okay? Published by International Code Council. So this is the organization that updates and revises this code. A model building code is a recommended building code that is developed by national organization that specializes in writing codes. Okay? When adopted by a government agency, the IRC regulates the construction, renovation, maintenance, repair of buildings used as homes. The IRC by itself has no formal legal status, okay? Unless they are adopted. So that is the term, promulgated. If they are promulgated by the authorities, by the local authorities that governs a certain area, okay? That is the time that it gets the legal status in that area. And therefore, it is now become what? Unenforceable. It can be enforced by the police, okay? By the authorities. Okay? So they need to adapt and promulgate this. Okay? So this is the code that we are talking about. International Residential Code 2015. The IRC has no jurisdiction of its own, but is the basis for many state and local residential building codes. So even if your local authorities do not adopt and promulgate these codes, you can follow it. You can follow a code so that your family will become safer, will feel safer. Okay? It's better to follow best practices. So it is only a best practice type of document. Okay? So, state and local building codes. Almost all areas of the United States have adopted some version of building code. Some states such as California, Florida, and New York have a state building code. Some large cities such as Chicago and New York have city building code. So it depends upon the what? The area. Even city can have their own building code. Okay? Many of these states and local building codes are based on model building codes from ICC. So there are model building codes in ICC that are being what? Adopted and promulgated in their local area. For example, North Carolina State Building Code. So, okay. Some states and cities have their own building codes. Smaller cities, counties. Counties are like barangays. Counties are like barangays. Okay, and they are using codes in the barangay, so, or municipality. Counties are some municipalities, okay? So, they have engineering codes. However, in the Philippines, in our country, Even towns do not have codes that are being followed. They are just what? Using the National Building Code of the Philippines, and actually they are not enforcing those codes if they are encountering what? The residential owners. They do not. Okay? Some rural areas may not have adopted the building code, but this is becoming a rare situation. So it is an exemption in the United States to have an area without building code. They almost have building codes in every location. So if you do any work that is regulated by the local building code, you are responsible for knowing or for hiring someone. Okay. If you do any work that is regulated, so you have to be aware of that area. If that area is asking this document, requiring this permit, so you have to be responsible for knowing or for hiring someone who knows the applicable building code where the building is located. Ignorance of the code is no excuse. So that is the same with us. In our country, ignorance of the law excuses no one. Okay. Local code amendments. Most building departments that use IRC adopt local changes to the IRC. So they adopt the IRC, but they impose some changes. Okay. So some of these changes can significantly alter IRC provisions. The building department should publish in writing any changes adopted. So that is for legal requirement. They should be published. So in the Philippines, we have a requirement that any rules, policies should be published and be only allowed to be enforced after 30 days? Okay. I think 15, 30 or 60 days. So I'm not currently aware of the actual situation today. So that is just a requirement for the provision to be, for the code to be enforceable and legal. Ask the building official if there are any local codes. You can actually ask, go to the engineering officials. Okay? So other building codes, there are so many other building codes. We are also using some of this and referring to this. Okay, for example, other commonly used building codes include International Building Code, IBC. So our building codes in the country sometimes refer to this. Okay, sometimes. International Mechanical Code. Okay. The International Plumbing Code. This is being used. International Plumbing Code and the Uniform Plumbing Code, UPC. UPC is being used in the Philippines. Is called UPCP, Uniform Plumbing Code of the Philippines, UPCP. Okay? Okay? International Fuel Gas Code, I am not aware of this, if this is being referred to in the Philippines. National Electrical Code, this is being referred to and used some sort of in the Philippines. Sometimes, Philippine Electrical Codes, there are some small provision that they adopt, and the PAR code, Fire Code of the Philippines, use National Electrical Code, and also use Philippine Electrical Code at the same time. Okay? And International Energy Conservation Code, I am not aware of this. So National Plumbing Code of the Philippines. NPCP. NPCP, National Plumbing Code of the Philippines. Always, almost the same with IPC. So that is for plumbing engineers or master plumber and sanitary engineers, UPCP. So, and International Building Code for structural. So these are some of the very popular and mostly referred to by the local code in the Philippines. IBC, that's what I am explaining. IBC is for structural, being referred to in the Philippines. But mostly, not on the real Republic Act, but on some memorandums and some policies, rules of the authority having jurisdiction. So they are adapting this sometimes. Okay. So there are also some differences in the local. It's AHJ's taste to adapt or make some rules locally. So, okay. So plumbing, I already said it. UPC is actually for sanitary engineers. Okay. So I already explained this. So different chapters, no? So we will tackle this on each and every chapters, starting from the next chapter. Okay. So let's ask our local building official which code applies to your area. I will do it for you because in our country, codes are national in nature, not on provincial level, not on city level. Okay? They are national in nature. So I will state it to you later on. Okay. Trade-oriented building codes with a more specific focus apply in some situation. Most of these are primarily for non-residential construction, but they are also important, like what? NEC. NEC is very must-used code. And the association that do this is NAPA. And the code number is NAPA 70. So, NAPA 70. So you are responsible for knowing and complying with them. In larger jurisdictions, planning and zoning departments may be separate from building inspection department. So this is not true in the Philippines. They are the same. That is office of the building official. They are all there. They are all there. The inspectors and the checker of the plans, of the engineering plans, the approving authority are all in the same department in the Philippines. Each and every town, cities have this set up. Okay? It only depends upon how big is the city. For very small cities, only one engineer is responsible for everything. In some cities, there are two. In large cities, like us, there are several engineers. There are electrical engineer, there are mechanical engineer, sanitary engineer, geodetic engineer, there are civil engineer, there are architect, there are electronics engineer. Okay? So a complete set of engineering in one department, headed by the office of the building official. Okay. So that is how it works. So buildings governed by IRC. Apply the IRC to building containing one or more individual residential dwelling units in one building. So one or two family dwelling. Duplex is a common term for one building containing two individual dwelling units, duplex. So a building with back-to-back or side-by-side, so duplex. Apply the IRC to townhouses. You can do it. A townhouse contains at least three individual dwelling units. In one building, right? So one or two family dwellings, if there are three units, that is townhouse. Okay? Each dwelling unit in any building within scope of IRC must have separate means of egress. It's important. We'll talk about this many times from now on. This often interpreted to mean that each dwelling unit must have a separate door to the outside. Okay? Means of egress, separate door. Or if there are three units or three separate doors going out. Apply the IRC to a residential building with not more than three stories above grade plane. Oh. With not more than three stories. So, one story or two stories. Okay, so this is the problem of this code. A story above grade plane is one where the finished floor is entirely above. Entirely above grade plane. Or B is more than 6 feet above grade plane. 6 feet above grade plane, that is about 2 meters above grade plane. Okay? That is counted as story above grade plane. Letter C is more than 12 feet above finished ground level at any point. So 12 feet, that is about 5.5 meters. Okay? At any point. Okay? So that is how we define what is a story above grade plane. So if there are three stories above grade plane, this is not applicable. So we will only apply this up to two stories above grade plane. Okay? So okay, what else? Okay. What happened? Apply IRC to all single family homes. To all single family homes. Even if they are big enough, this can be applied because this is single family home. Okay? Okay. Apply IRC to multiple family buildings such as duplex and townhomes. So townhomes, duplex, this can be used. So building departments, a local building department enforces the building code in its jurisdiction. A technical open use to describe this department is AHJ. This is what I'm saying all along. AHJ, meaning authority having jurisdiction. Technical term. This is the term to describe the person responsible for enforcing the code of the building official or chief building official. The public name for local building department varies by jurisdiction. Sometimes we'll have the terms building or safety somewhere in the name. In some larger jurisdictions, the building department may be the division of a larger agency that is also responsible for land planning, zoning, and development. This is true in the Philippines. This is true in the Philippines. Not some, all the time. This is on the same. So the zoning department, that's why in the Philippines, the engineering plan have zoning signature, approval. Okay? Zoning and development, land use. Some building department names may not sound like they are anything at all to do with building code enforcement. If you do any work that requires building permit, you are responsible for finding and contacting the building department. Okay. You are the one responsible. You are the homeowner. Or you are the representative of the homeowner. You are paid by the homeowners to do the building. Okay? If you do any work that requires building permit, you will ask the government, you will ask the AHJ for the permit, building permit. Work done without a permit can have serious legal and financial consequences. What do you mean by this? You could be penalized and asked to pay for damages. Okay, so that is what do you mean? Okay, this city of Swainsboro, a local area in the United States, okay, working with government inspector, what do they do? What do they look for if they inspect your site? Okay, the building official is the king of his building jurisdiction. So the office of building official is very powerful in that area. Okay. He can stop the construction of any building in his area. Okay. Don't mess with the king. He can make your life very difficult. Okay, that's correct. That's true. If you must disagree with him, do so respectfully and with facts that support your position. So, hindi pwede yung, ay, kasi tinanong ko si ano, ganito. Because of gossip and what? Third person reference. Use documents, use facts in order to show your position if you disagree with him. But most of the times, you have to do it respectfully. The building official has the right to interpret any code, provision. This is correct. The building official has the right to interpret. That is very true. And sometimes, this is dangerous. This is very dangerous. Okay. While he does not have the right to waive code provision or to require more than the code requires, interpretations can sometimes have the effect, even if his interpretation seems unreasonable, eventually it will probably prevail. Okay? In almost all cases, you should just smile and do what he tells you. This is how it works in the Philippines. This is how it works in the United States, even though they have what? Codal requirements, written documents. It's still happening. Okay? Most building officials and inspectors are honest, hardworking people, so they are given, they can be valuable resource. Take advantage of that resource. Ask questions and work with them. Most will in turn work with you. A city building inspector is accustomed to what? Making site inspection in person. So that is not really true in the Philippines. Okay? That's not really true in the Philippines. But they are allowed to really inspect the site. And I have been involved with a project that there is an inspector that is really visiting the area. And that is what? Less than 10% of the time. In other areas, they are not inspecting. Okay? Working with private building inspector. I am saying this just to let you know the current situation. But that is not the supposed to be the way it is. No? And don't expect that all of the time. If the building official retires and changes with another building official which is more strict with the enforcement of the code, so it will become a problem. So it's better to be prepared always. Do not take advantage of a building official that is not inspecting the site. Okay? Still follow the code. Okay? From an 8-hour day, they must subtract doing paperwork, discussing inspections with stakeholders, traveling between inspections, and performing other duties. So divide the remaining time by 20 to 30 inspections per day or more, they may have only few minutes to perform each. Okay? So, uy, nagnawa, nalagyan ng ano. Okay? It's a credit to government inspector that they find major code violation. Most will admit, however, that they cannot find all code violation. They will also admit that they are not even looking for issues, that although they are not code violation, can have significant negative impact. So, this is not so good. This is not good because at the end of the day, your family's life and safety is at stake. So all of this should be given importance and seriously done the right way. So private building inspectors fill this quality control gap for many people. People building homes and people performing major remodeling project hire a public, private building inspector. So they are allowed in the United States. I don't have any news here in the Philippines about this. They are actually hiring third party design engineers or construction engineers to assess, evaluate the design and construction. But this is private building inspector is not implemented in the Philippines. Third party design engineer or third party construction engineer to assess, evaluate your design and construction practices. There is a provision in the Philippine code. There is a provision for that. I do not know if they are being applied and how frequently they are being applied, but that is a provision that could be used by any interested party. Okay? So that is with the private inspector. When building a new home or doing major remodeling, okay, project, private inspector is often most useful at two critical points. Okay, most critical point is just before insulation and drywall are installed. So this is a problem in the United States because they have insulation on the wallings and structure because what? Four season. They have four season. In the Philippines, we do not have. So we can do away with this provision. This inspection is sometimes called pre-drywall inspection. So at this time, inspector can see many important components that will be covered. Finishing materials, in most cases, will never be visible again. So after that, they are very much in contact with the inspector and with the site engineer. But in the Philippines, this is nothing. There's no provision for this because we have two seasons, dry season, summer season, and rainy season. And that's all. We do not need that drywalling, blah, blah, blah inspection. Private inspectors are increasingly common in construction site in the United States. Okay, so, but their use in the United States is very much in demand, required, and wise thing to do. Okay, so that's for the building inspection. Let's go to manufacturer's instructions. private building inspection. So there are contractors work at key points. So probably this is what? Mechanical and electrical contractor.
Okay.
No. They are on the panel board, so most probably electrical. IRC requires installing all components, equipment, and appliances according to manufacturer's instruction. This requirement is so important that it is repeatedly many times in the IRC, manufacturer's instruction are unenforceable extension of IRC. So, manual, manufacturer's instruction, how to install something. No? Manufacturer's instructions are an important part of ensuring that components are safe. Independent organization tests make components used to build home. This includes almost all manufactured components. So there are testing association, testing organization. So let us, this process is called listing. So are you familiar with UL? United Laboratories, they are a testing laboratory and at the same time listing laboratory. They will list your product if you pass their standard. So, and it is a good and advantageous to the company doing that product because it is an added marketing tool that their product passed the UL standard and listed product. So, one example is UL. There are other organizations, not only UL. There are other organizations that list and test the products. Okay? So, all of these are true. This is why the IRC usually defers to manufacturer's instruction. Because there are, they assume that manufacturer is the better person to know its product and how it should be installed. And it is reliable because if they are listed and tested by third party like UL, well, that is a good. Okay? Okay? Manufacturer's instruction and IRC. So, manufacturer's instruction is like this for each and every equipment, appliance, and so on. Okay? So, very important, not in the Philippines. They are almost never being given importance in the Philippines. This piece of paper, this piece of paper is not given importance in the Philippines. Nobody will read this piece of paper. And nobody will what? Nobody will take hold of this paper and file it for future reference. Nobody will. So they are just using the gadgets, equipment, device, and let somebody who knows this very much do it, and that's all. That is how we do it in the country. Okay, gathering, existing work. So this is not something we experience in the Philippines. This is also purely in the United States. In almost all situations, you are not required to abandon, remove, or alter existing work that is lawfully in existence and safely functioning. Lawful existence means that work was inspected and complied with the code when installed or modified. In almost all situations, when updating, modifying, repairing of existing work, you are required to perform update, modification, or repairing according to the code enforced when work is performed. You are usually not required to make the existing work comply with current code. In the Philippines, alteration, modification, you need what? Engineering plan. If the original work has engineering plan, you need that. And if the addition, alteration, and modification falls under those listed activities that requires engineering plan, you will be required to have those. So it is the duty of the engineer or the owner, homeowner, to know that. So if the owner do not know it, so we have to hire an engineer to implement that, to ask question how to do it. Okay? So, building permits and inspection. Contact your local building official to determine which construction activities require building permit and to determine the documents and procedures required to obtain a permit. The building official you speak may not enforce some building permit requirements contained in the IRC, but may add. So this is correct. This is true. Similarly true in the Philippines. So you have to what? Report to the building official and they will what? Inform you that, for example, you can call us and schedule an inspection, but let us inform 3 days before the schedule. 3 days or 1 week before. So that is some requirement. Okay, so this is also the same in the Philippines. Beginning work before permit is issued. So this is correct. It may result in fines if you do not follow this rule, and the building official could require removal of the work. Comply with the building code applicable to where the building is located. So if you do not obtain a building permit, comply with the building code in force when the work is performed. So that is generally the case in the country. Okay? The building code applies whether or not you obtain building permit or not. This is important. Lack of building permit does not relieve the building owner or contractor of responsibility to code compliance. Okay? When is the permit required? Okay. You typically will need a building permit for construction of new buildings, additions, modifications, structural repairs. Okay. Those are the types of activities that you need building permit. Okay. Replacement, major repairs, roof coverings like exterior walls, movement and demolition of demolition requires building permit in the country, in the Philippines. Changes to building occupancy requires another permit. A change to building occupancy means changing how the building is used. Example, using single family home as a place for business is a change in occupancy that requires building permit and may require zoning change or zoning waiver. Okay. Additions, that is always a requirement, but we do not usually enforce it, and that's why accident happens. They always ask for residential building permit, and afterwards, the establishment will become what? Commercial later on, and they will not do anything about it. Okay. Is building or installation of one-story detached accessory structures. Okay. There are detached structure, for example, storage, playhouse, with a floor area not more than 200 square feet. Okay. You are exempted from building permit. 200 square feet. Okay. So if you divide it by 9, so divide 20. So about 25 square meter, no? So, if the additional structure, single stats accessory structure, do not have more than 25 square meters of floor area, it is about, that is about 200 square feet. Okay? Fences, not more than 7 feet tall. Okay. Excuse me. So, we have a separate permit for fence. That is called fencing permit. I already have an experience signing a plan for a fencing permit of one city, the Philippines. Okay? So, separate permit for fence and requires six feet rather than 7 feet, 6 feet fence. Okay? Because U.S. citizens are what? Their people are taller. We in the Philippines are shorter. maybe that is the reason why. Retaining walls not more than 4 feet tall, measured from the bottom of the footing to the top. So this is requiring a building permit, but actually they are not doing it. The practicing engineer do not practice it, mostly, most of the time, but they are required, okay? And most of the civil engineers in the Philippines know that. However, in the actual world, they are not being asked for a permit for what? For that kind of structure. Okay. So exempted, that is actually exempted if the wall is not supporting surcharge. Okay? There is no surcharge. A surcharge is a vertical load in addition to and or above the retained ground. So my load, surcharge, retaining wall is horizontal, surcharge, horizontal. Okay? Driveways and sidewalks are what? Exempted from permit. Painting, papering, floor covering, installation, cabinet, and so on. Finishing work, exempted from permit. Installation of portable plug and cord, decorative lights, exempted. Low voltage lights, operating at less than 25 volts, there's no such thing in the country. And not more than 50 watts, there's no such thing in the provision, the country. Installation of portable gas, heating, cooking, clothes, drying equipment. Portable, that's why exempted. Okay? Installation of portable HVAC equipment, portable, that's why exempted. Clearing of plumbing stoppages and repair of plumbing leaks, immobile, exempted. Decks that are not more than 30 inches above ground. So, if the decks are lower than 30 inches, so 30 inches is about 30 inches is about 800 mm, so about 800 mm, 12, 24, so about like this, no? Okay. And do not serve the required egress door. So if that flooring do not serve egress door, so that is exempted. Okay. Why? Because in the egress, you are going to panic and go out of the door at the same time. So that is the purpose of this. You usually do not need a building permit for routine maintenance work, building fixtures, equipment, if the building structure is not affected, and if the nature and use of electrical, plumbing, gas, or HVAC is not changed. So you need certificate of occupancy issued by your building official to affirm that your structure is safe to inhabit. So after building permit, after the construction, you need certificate of occupancy. Occupancy permit, okay? In the country, that is the name of this permit. Do not move into or occupy a building until after occupancy permit is issued by the building official. Do not change the use of the building without a new certificate of occupancy. So change the occupancy type. Need a new permit. May require changes to the building that reflects its new commercial use. From residential to commercial, you need another occupancy permit. If you are not required to obtain certificate of occupancy for accessory structure, so exempted for accessory structure. Exempted, and that is the picture of occupancy certificate. Almost similar in the Philippines, almost similar. Okay, permit expiration. So in the Philippines, building permit may expire more than 180 days. Okay. In the Philippines, the building permit may expire 1 year. 1 year. Okay. 180 days is 6 months. 6 months. Okay. So, I'm getting confused if in the Philippines this is correct. So I will adjust. I will make a statement of how long. There is a similar provision in the Philippines, but that is in terms of months and year. So I will make a specific check on this, if this is 1 year or 6 months, because they are 6 months in their area. In the Philippines, I think it is 1 year, but I will make a confirmation about that. So 6 months or 1 year. Okay. That is the expiry date of building permit. Required inspections. Contact building officials to determine the required inspections for construction project. So each jurisdiction has its own rules. So that is the same. These rules include which inspection it performs, what work must be complete before requesting the inspection, and how when to schedule inspection. This is correct. How it handles inspection of work that fails inspection. So after failing the inspection, what is going to happen afterwards? Okay, so note that some jurisdictions conduct separate inspection for each trade. So that is correct in our country. Different inspection for electrical, mechanical, civil, plumbing, sanitary, electronics, so different inspection. But the most basic ones are plumbing, electrical, structural. Those are the most used and generally applied inspection, okay, in our country. So we have to check with the local building official. So further required inspection may include floodplain, elevation, roof covering, insulation, energy efficiency, interior drywall, exterior wall. So these are the details from the United States. There is no similar provision for in our country. Final inspection. So we have this type. Installation of plumbing, HVAC, electrical fixture, equipment, appliances. You should inspect, okay? Or let them inspect and approve. Okay, handrails, guards. So there is a law that requires this in the Philippines, but they are not being implemented. Handrails, guards, and for disabled person, for disabled. So there is a law. However, they are not being strict in the implementation of this. Safety glazing and smoke alarms. So these are required in the next installment of the fire code. So as of today, they are not being strict about this, but there is now an IRR or implementing rules and regulation for this. So smoke alarms and so on. So note that jurisdictions have different rules. These rules in the Philippines I will repeat this, national in nature, national level, almost every jurisdiction locally have the same code and rules to follow. Okay. Jurisdiction also differs on whether tasks such as final grading and landscaping must be installed. There is a law about this, but they are again not being strict on the implementation. There are licensed landscape architects, but they are not being implemented in the Philippines. Do not assume that passing an inspection or receiving a certificate of occupancy is a waiver of any code violations. The building owner and contractor are responsible for any code violation regardless of whether the building has passed inspection. This is not the same with your exam in high school or elementary or even in college. If you are checked in your exam, you are checked and you will be graded that way. However, in the building, if you are approved, correct, check correct, inspected correct, and they missed something about the inspection, and the building failed, the building collapsed, still the owner of the building is responsible for this. Okay? This is not a waiver of code violation. If there is a code violation and the inspector was not able to find the violation and was approved, do not be happy about this, because still you are responsible for this. So that's why buildings have maintenance engineer. Building have to be inspected yearly. Buildings have to be inspected yearly, particularly commercial. And because you love your family, you can do so. You can let engineers inspect your dwelling units. Okay? So preparing for inspection looks like this. At the onset, foundation, just starting the foundation. Inspection, concrete footings. Inspection must be done before concrete is poured. Try to coordinate the inspection for the day before the plant pour, so you leave enough time to make. Install square and level forms. Dig footing and pier trenches. Install and required reinforcing bars. So those are required. Okay? So, there are no reinforcing bars on the footings yet, no? Okay? So, needs inspection. Isolated footings, okay? Such as those used for support deck, columns, okay, must be inspected before the concrete is poured. The footings will be inspected for size and depth. Some footings may require reinforcing bars. So, reinforcing bars could be put and then let the inspector see. Even if there are reinforcing bars, you can still measure the depth. Okay? Okay. Concrete foundation wall have to be inspected. So, forms. Yeah? Install a square, straighten, plumb, secure wall form. Install any required reinforcing bar. So, if there are any. So, it is not usually used in the Philippines, but there are buildings that use this. However, in residential, we almost always use hollow blocks. Okay? Plumbing, wrapping in, inspection. So, this must happen. So, install plumbing water supply and drain pipes. There are water test, water leak, and air leak test. So, and also the pressure test measurement. Okay, so those are the minimum three testing that must be done during the inspection. Okay? So, building sewer inspection is usually the different inspection. Install fixtures such as tubs and showers that may be difficult to install after the wall. Okay. So, and that is under the area of master plumber in the country. Tubs and shower. Okay. So, construction is... okay, so these are what? Electrical, wrapping in, inspection. So that is electrical. Junction box, okay? So, wrapping in. Have electrical service panel and sub panel cabinets installed. Okay, service panel. But do not put the coverings, no? Install boxes for switches, receptacles, and fixtures, and all electrical cables. So, you have to install it, but leave the coverings open. HVAC inspection. Install HVAC ducts, pipes, and thermostat wires. Install appliances such as furnaces and other air handlers that may be difficult to install after the construction is complete. This is not being done, particularly in residential area in the Philippines. In commercial, it could be done, but in residential area, it's not done because we just what buy what window type air conditioning system, and that's all. And buy what electric fan and exhaust fans. So that's all. There's no need for this, and usually not being inspected. Because we are looking at what? One family, two family, and townhouse. Okay? Framing inspection. They are being inspected in the United States, but in the Philippines, they are not. Install exterior, interior walls, floor joists, some flooring, ceiling joists, rafters. Okay? Note that some jurisdictions may require installation of other components such as moisture barriers and roofing felt before. This one is the problem on that recently collapsed building in Miami, Florida. There are what? Moisture that came from the sea because this is very near the beach, the beach front. Okay? And the building has its own what? What do you call this? Swimming pool on the lower portion of the building. So the moisture and water seeps through the foundation and structural elements and damage the strength of the reinforcing steel bars. So this is one problem encountered with that collapsed building. So that's all. And if you have any question, this page is now on the chapter 2. So we will tackle that on the next meeting. So let us stop on the chapter 1. And if you have any question, just put in or post your question on the comment box below. And we will always read your comments and answer your questions. So thank you very much for listening. And once again, this is Dr. AP, your samurai engineer at your service.